Hello everyone, my name is Teriprism and welcome back to XCOM 2. Now, before we actually continue our game, I'm going to address one question I got, but I wasn't able to answer it because that question was in comment that somehow disappeared before I could answer it. Not sure if original commentator deleted it or did just... Did it just disappear as I heard some rumors that some YouTube comments do that. So I was able to see it, but I wasn't fast enough to respond it because I was busy at the time, and about half hour later when I went to respond to it, it was gone. So anyway, question was, am I getting bored of this game? Because I'm apparently rushing. Well, answer is no, I'm not getting bored of this game. And am I rushing? Maybe. Let's just go over with that rushing part first. Am I getting bored of this part first? I'm far from getting bored. I'm actually can't wait to start my own campaign, because I'll show you. I only have this save of this game, because I don't want to accidentally, because I love this game so much. I don't want to accidentally go farther than I am in this campaign myself while playing without recording this. So it's anything but getting bored of this game. Now, about part if I'm rushing. I might be, but I wouldn't know that because, like I just told you, I only have this save at the moment. So I don't know how long this game actually will last, and I can only make guesses about it. And if I'm rushing, that's possibly because of two reasons. One, because I love this game so much, I might unconsciously rush this, so I could start this again without actually recording this. And two, because I'm trying to keep gameplay as fast as possible. Well, not as fast as possible, but trying to avoid that avatar project getting completed. Those are possible reasons why I might be rushing so far. But anyway, now that I addressed that question, let's just continue the game. Also, last episode we lost two more soldiers. Let's see. Ptolemy, I'm completely blamed on this one myself. I put him on a completely wrong position considering that layout there, and he got stuck in a really bad place, and I couldn't get him out as well as I wanted, and then enemy got lucky shot and finished him off. And we also lost Fleming, partly because of same reason as Ptolemy. He was positioned too close to Ptolemy, and that sector bot's bombardment destroyed his cover, and after that just destroyed him too. Anyway, let's just continue this game properly now. There we go, and let's start by assaulting this CODEX brain coordinates mission. Nice amount of supplies too, should help us get through it. Or through this a little bit faster. Now, just give me a moment to set up my squad, and I will be right back. And welcome back. Our squad this time will be Copernicus as our sharpshooter, Lavos here as our ranger. Little bit of unexperienced there, but hopefully he will make up for that. Then Einstein as our grenadier, then bring in Johansen as our medic, then Dirac as our psy-operative, and then Tesla as our combat hacker. Let's start this mission.
Sky Ranger deploy.
Squad green to deploy.
Shen and Tigan barely managed to pull these coordinates from that CODEX thing they had down in the Shadow Chamber. We're guessing this may be its origin point, but can't know for sure. Based on the fight it put up, I'd expect heavy resistance either way. Good luck down there.
Operation God Valley will start now. I hope I didn't make mistake bringing a little bit unexperienced squad on this one. But we will see.
Target coordinates are just ahead. Move to investigate the site. Hostile presence is currently unknown, but expect the worst. The squad is concealed.
Let's start with Lavos here, then. Move him all the way over there.
Okay, Jabouche.
Well, we found one of them at least. Let's get the Johansen on that half
twice.
Over there. And then Dirac all the way over here.
Getting it done.
Copernicus will stay a little bit behind on that full cover here. I want him to be on overwatching.
Scanning.
Just in case. Then Tesla. Where can I move you? Stay close to... Stay close there. And then Einstein. Go over there.
Overwatch.
And that berserker moved in a really bad place. I can't see anything from there. Plenty of wipers too, from those sounds. Now, how do I approach them without triggering alarms? Let's try with Dirac and moving him on this side
to
here.
Location.
I wasn't expecting that. Really, I wasn't expecting three of them so straight away. Or so soon, rather. Well, that happened then. And I can't really move people too close here. If I move Tesla over here, and then put that kill zone up.
On the move.
I will be ambushing them straight away. Alright, it takes two turns. Not so good. On the other hand, if I give 8 proto... No, that's not good either. Or it might actually be. He would still have that overwatch shot. But I'm just not happy about this. These chances I'm currently having here. I kind of want to start with the acid, but that's not good either.
Moving to position.
Just take that full cover there and overwatch.
Scouting.
Johansen, how's your... Yeah, I have to put you on overwatch here.
Scanning.
Yeah, you give 8 protocol on. Dirac here. Giving him overwatch. Then Copernicus go overwatch there, and let's see if we can dominate one of them. You.
Don't fight. Let it happen.
There we go. As I expected. And now triggering those overwatch shots. Easy and clean work.
One down, thousands to go.
Oh. Didn't see that one over there. I don't want to burn my mimic beacon just yet. But can I get... Not really. Little bit too far. But if I move him here, I should be able to shoot that berserker here and hopefully take him out. If I get a crit, I will be able to take him out. Good thing I got that.
Cible abattu.
Enemy's turn. I don't like that mech here, but luckily they seem to focus on that berserker. And there goes that shield. And overwatch shot from Copernicus. Oh, yes!
Enemy's down.
That was lucky. Next, let's use Berserker first. And let's see if we can take out him. Doesn't look like it. We need to be close enough. And he's just a little bit too far over there. So let's just go from here. And you missed. Of course you did. Let's move people closer. Well, can't really get the clean shots here, what's but the cover, that half cover. 48% chance. Well, we got that, but not good enough. Lavos here, I want to get you down, but there's really not full cover over there. So instead, stay up there. That's just too low chance, so stay on Overwatch. Now, can I get you? Not really. I'll have to put you on half cover there. Still quite a low chance to hit. But with Soulfire, it's guarantee one. But on other hand, if I go with Insanity, I might be able to get the... let's go with Insanity instead. And he panicked, luckily. I didn't want you to shoot here just yet. Oh well. Luckily you hit him.
Ça manque de force.
And you hit something over there. Oh, there was Chrysalis. Luckily, we didn't run into them ourselves. Let's get the Tesla closer. And I should have used that fire zone on him. But let's get Einstein on that half cover here.
Alright, I'll go.
And let's see if you can get... I don't want to waste this acid bomb on just that one guy. And it's still quite far away, so... Let's just suppress him.
Bring in the PM.
And can you finish that officer off? 49% chance with 7% crit. Might not actually be worth it, so just go on Overwatch. And let's get you all the way over here.
On it.
Thing that missed. And that Chrysalid still stays away. So let's start with Berserker once again. Let's go with the melee hit from here. good that the that's down. Then not going to move Dirac just yet. I'll try to get that officer first. Let's see if we can get him with Einstein from up here. Alright, you need to reload. So do you have a free reload? I forgot completely that. Free reload and 100% chance to hit and finish off this officer here.
There you go.
Next, let's get the Johansen on half power over here. And let's try to get that sealed beer. Missed.
Get it together. Burn it
through fast. Maybe next shot. If we move Dirac over here, he might be able to. No, it's not flanked shot here, but let's take him out with soul fire.
You're melting.
Still one more hit, and it needs to be somewhat good hit too. So Copernicus on that full cover, and no, you can't reach him with just pistol. So just stay up there. See if we can get him with Lavoisier from going to take a little bit risky on that half cover, but no, I don't want to hit him. I want you to try to hit that sealed bearer. Good. Now there's that chrysalid there, somewhere over there. I'm actually going to put this up.
Area on lockdown.
Nothing yet. Let's move berserker. We need to keep use him as our scout here. There's that chrysalid. Hopefully you can. Not bad hit. Not bad at all. And let's see if we can finish him off with Copernicus. You can see that chrysalid. Just great. In that case, we just move you on full cover over there. And Lavoisier, full cover. And you can see him either. How about you, Einstein, if I move you on that half cover? You should be able to see that chrysalid there. No, you can't. So just turn over once then. And Johansen on full cover.
Got it covered.
Overwatch. Dirac on full cover. and Overwatch.
Scanning.
And Tesla just dash up in here.
Copy that.
And Lavos here on Overwatch.
Rest on observation.
Scanning.
There's another Chrysalid there. What's it going to do? Well, anything going to happen here, or apparently nothing. That was a bit strange. Let's see if we can hit that Chrysalid with the Copernicus. Yes, we can. Should be quite cool to be hit. But it didn't die.
Deflection!
Let's get the Lavos here a little bit closer. And 61% chance to hit. Take it. And that was a miss.
Allez, on se reprend. Mon arme est à sec.
Let's get Tesla. No, Johansen.
I hope it's worth it.
Up here. Maybe you can... No, you can't even see him. So, just on Overwatch. Dirac. Move close to Johansen. And let's get Tesla up here.
Heading out.
And Overwatch time. Let's get Einstein on the full cover here.
All right, I'll go.
And finish off that Chrysalid hopefully. There we go.
Okay, so I got one.
Train and ammo fast!
And he got promoted. Okay, apparently I can't even target that unconscious Chrysalid there. Let's move you all the way over there.
I've got a burrow here.
And there's that Chrysalid. Straight to ambushes.
Armor still holding.
Well, we lost our berserker. And uncovered a second Chrysalid. No. Oh no. That's not good. How many Chrysalids are there? Oh no. There's even more. That's not good. Let's start with the Dirac hitting this closest one here. Good,
check
that's
it,
down.
Too close.
No. Oh no. Don't get too close. How many of them there are? At least three more in the shadows and these two over here. Yeah, I need to reload everyone.
Bye.
I was here. You take out this closest one. Good.
Bon débarras.
Johansen, reload. And take out this one here. 95% chance.
Big deal.
And it was free action too. Great. So I can put you on Overwatch instead.
Overwatch.
Irak, I don't want to move you too close. Let's put Copernicus on long watch. And Killzone is still on the cooldown zone. Going to give Lavos here 8 protocol. So he can overwatch. And put actually I'm going to move you little bit closer over there.
I'm on it.
And then Iraq on that full cover. You didn't trigger anything yet. But you found the Chrysalid cocoon. And you're little bit too far away to hit it with grenade. Let's see, what can we... Can we get it with... Einstein. I need to move just a little bit closer and we might be able to take it out. Over there.
I hope it's worth it.
I hope so too. And now, as it. Just barely hitting it, but it's worth it. That way, if there's any chrysalids coming out of them, they run through that acid. And let's give Inspire for Einstein. So we can put him on Overwatch.
Covering now.
How many of them are incoming? Anything going to happen? Yeah, I'm playing it safe here. I really hate those chrysalids. Oh dear. I'm not liking this. Yeah, let's take out that cocoon now. And if we can, alright, we can't really do that. Let's move Lobos here a little bit closer here. Quite bad chances to hit, so just putting him on Overwatch. Johansen will be moved a little bit closer here. And you can't see anything yet, so just Overwatch. Copernicus just stay on Overwatch there. And I'll be putting up a kill zone with Tesla here.
Kill zone confirmed.
And moving Einstein closer We might actually trigger those chrysalids. No, we didn't. So just overwatch there. That one chrysalid right next to us. That's not good. It didn't shoot or anything like that. So let's just why can't you see anything there? Oh well, I'll just move you here.
All right, I'll go.
And you still can't see anything. Well, that's strange. So let's just put you on overwatch. Then, Lavo's here. Yeah, I'll have to move you here. You can finally see them. Though I'm not sure if that's good or bad thing. Especially with so many of them in here. And you can't reach with that gas bomb. Yeah, let's start taking them out with Copernicus. Fire it. And hit him. I said hit him.
Not even close!
Why I can't target this one here?
What's
go next
there?
To Johansen and then go on overwatch.
Watch.
56% chance, but not good enough in my opinion, especially with the chrysalids around here. Let's get the Tesla over here. And don't really see much use with that, so just overwatch. Yeah, I can't target this chrysalid here. That's bad. So just reload and then overwatch. Yeah, this one might have bugged somehow. And I don't feel right wasting up a grenade against it. Yeah, that's really strange. Can I just reload?
Let's do this.
And let's get you close. No, just the pistol overwatch there. Let's move Lavos here up here.
I'm not
well,
sure
what's
we're
that?
Expecting to find out here, but this definitely.
Not the same rift the Codex used when it appeared. This thing could lead anywhere. It may not even be pointing at Earth.
As with most things, we'll likely need to bring it back to the ship for further examination.
That's not good. I was going to attack those chrysalids, but now there's this gatekeeper here. So I'm actually going to go and toss up this mimic beacon here to keep them a little bit busy instead of us. And where's Tesla? There you are. You are a little bit too far to put up the 8 protocol. But Lavos here really needs it. 8 protocol for Lavos here. Even if he is in full cover, he's closest one to all those enemies and... yeah. Let's see, what kind of plasma grenade? Who had that incendiary? You. So, if I move you
okay,
here,
I'll go.
You might be able to reach those chrysalids. No, you can't. You're just a little bit too far away. How's insanity? How about soul fire on that gatekeeper? Yeah, that one might be best choice here. That should do it. Now we need to take care of that gatekeeper.
I'm going.
So going to grenade it. To remove a little bit of that armor too. Can't really rocket him, or can you? You can!
With pleasure!
That should make our job a little bit easier once more. So what are you going to do now? Anything? Am I worrying just too much here? They just don't seem to do anything here. They actually aren't doing anything. Can you get all of them? Well, chrysalids are more important to get down now. So, get that gas grenade over there. What kind of chances do you have? Take that 73% chance. One down, three more to go. And just reload.
Rock and roll!
Hmm. 79% chance.
So I got one.
How about you? Hmm. If you can take out that one last chrysalid, no you can't. So take shot at that gatekeeper. He's dead.
Hippie armor!
This actually might be much easier than I originally thought. Let's just get the...
All right,
Einstein over here. He should be able to shoot that gatekeeper. That's not very good chances, and I rather take out that 71% chance with that chrysalid.
Big deal.
And let's see. You're only one with moves left, but if I put give Inspire to Lavos here, he should be able to take out that gatekeeper. Only 59% chance, but was good enough.
Cible abattue.
Was that everything? No, it wasn't. Where did that chrysalid go? No idea. Let's get the Johansen up here.
Is it clear?
Can you see anything? Yes, you can. 81% chance to hit. Take it. And next we move Lavos here up. And he should be able to finish that.
Let go.
Hundred percent chance. There we go.
Cible terre.
Status confirmed. All hostile contacts in the AO have been eliminated. The gateway is secure. Status confirmed. Commander, we've secured the psionic gateway, and recovery teams are en route to the site. Now it's up to Tigan and Shen to figure out what this thing does.
That went well. I hope someone else aside Einstein got promoted too. And Lavos here did quite a lot of work there, apparently. We are back to Avenger now. Let's see who got promoted and who didn't.
An impressive performance, Commander. Our troop skills are improving with every deployment.
Three promotions. Copernicus. Let's take steady hands. And what about Lavos here? He will go with the Shadow Step. No reaction shots. Thank you. And then Einstein. Well, it's going to be heavy ordnance. I love having extra grenades. And that's all for now.
The distinctive alien artifact we recovered from the field resembles a portal or gateway of some kind. Although we believe it provides the aliens with a means of long-distance travel, potentially beyond the confines of our world itself, it will take time before we could truly understand the gateway's function.
So let's begin researching that.
Based on what witnessed in the field, Commander, it is clear this psionic gateway provides the aliens with some means of far-off travel. It will be up to you to determine not only how it functions, but exactly where this gateway leads.
Yeah. And we got avatar progress down by 2. That's also great. Okay. Not sure if I like that idea of installing gateway that the enemy uses in our base or in the adventure. Not sure if I like that idea itself.
In order to analyze the alien psionic gateway we recovered, we will need to make the appropriate modifications to the Shadow Chamber first, Commander.
Well, anyway, thanks for watching. I will be seeing you next time. Goodbye!